Well, hi there again. Sorry it's been a while. Lots and lots and lots going on. Just a little bit of a shop update, just to let you know where we're going with stuff. Plasma's working fine, workshop's in a mess. We've had to move stuff around for our new acquisition, which is that. So hopefully I can get back into the sheet metal work again at some point. Obviously, gonna have to make it pay for itself. Pick this up for a song. Morgan Rushworth, Boxpan folder, circa 2010. Nice little machine, actually, except it was dropped off the lorry on delivery, which I'm seething about, but for what I paid for it, wouldn't exactly, you know, the damage wasn't that bad. We've bent one of the weight bars. I don't know whether you can see it, but that is definitely, as we say in this part of the world, on the piss. So we're gonna have to get some heat into that and straighten it out, because I'm worried that the weight distribution is gonna be a bit odd and it might twist the bending arm. I don't know, maybe not. I've had to take out all these pins. They were virtually seized solid. Just a nightmare. You can see that arm there has been bent, one of the clamping arms, so that's gonna have to be straightened out. As for all the tooling, it's actually not bad, apart from, if you see in the light there, you can see a few dinks. Not bad actually, one missing finger, which again is a little bit of a shit, but it is what it is. I'm just going through cleaning it all up and trying to true it up. You can see that I've been, these rails here, but they've been so brutal with the way in which they ratch these things up. They haven't got to be done up that tight. It's just crazy. I mean, my grandfather used to say there's three sorts of tight. There's loose, there's tight, and there's bastard tight. And these have just been done up just way too tight, and it's just dinked all of that. So I might take them all off. Might just take them all off. Take off all the fingers again, because I haven't finished playing with them anyway. Get all of that smoothed out, because every time you do up one of the little clamping bolts, it wants to move into one of these little, you might be able to see, one of these little dimples, which is just a little bit infuriating if you want to box pan, you know, if you want to do a nice pan fold nice and tight. The other thing that was missing, which was, again, well, like I say, here we go, look, you can see I've tidied this a little bit, that pin was stuck out here somewhere, and they were using it like it, I couldn't believe it. So the other thing that's missing, which I'm having to sort out, which is a little bit tight, but no stop. So bearing in mind that it's a Morgan Rushworth, everything is Imperial, which for our American friends is absolutely wonderful. I'm sure they know what they're talking about, but for us metric sorts, not so great. All of this was seized solid to move the fingers forward and back, depending on thickness material. I may well do a short video on how to use one. If anybody's interested, leave it in the comments below, but it's relatively straightforward. You just kind of need to know. But what I might do is just go through a whole tutorial of making a box from fusion sheet metal right the way through to actually making it. We'll use the fine cut consumables on the plasma, so we haven't got a laser cutter, we haven't got a notch or anything like that. We'll just use fine cut. And we'll make a little 2mm sheet metal box. Anyway, that's in the future. You can see by the bend handle, just look at that, dropped it off the bloody lorry. I just so annoyed. But there we go, it is what it is. You can see that the foot's bent up, look. There's not a lot we can do about that, but it is what it is. All of these were loose, so actually holding in the bend plate itself, it was just hanging in there, just held on by, well, will, I think, and rust. So anyway, yeah, that's the shop update. That's our new little tool. You can see I'm cleaning up the underside of the fingers here. There was so much rust and stuff in here, it's nearly, yeah, it just annoys me, that's all. Bits of the back here, yeah, there's some dinks and stuff there, so I'm just having to just grab a file and just lightly just take off the highest of it. Don't want to mess around too much with the machine surfaces. This piece here, for instance, I know I can feel that what they've been trying to do is bend thicker material than the machine's capable of. And what we've got, if I put a file across there, file that, is that you'll see that these are high. They just stand a bit proud because they've really put some grunt through them and they've pulled the hose a bit. And what that in turn has is this effect. Here is one that I've sorted. Can't move it for love nor money. Here's one that hasn't. You can see the fingers are loose. There's one. You see that movement there? Look. Those are done up tight. But there's no clamping. Well, I mean, that's no good if you're... There's another one. That. Those are done up tight. Those bolts are done up dead tight. But you got that. And the reason for that is that they have tried bending thicker material than it's capable of. It's only capable of 2.5 full length. That's millimetres, by the way. Not inches for for American guys. So they've pulled these and we've lost the clamping force. So when that clamps on there, yeah, that gap between there and there should be almost interference, so that when the, let's grab the finger. So that when the finger goes in there, like that. Sorry there, got a little interrupted. Neighbours coming in having a chat. Anyway, so what I was saying is that you can see that that is a fairly snug fit, to say the least. So if there's any marks or anything on the surfaces or rust on the surfaces, that clamping force is just not going to take place, so the finger won't be held tight. So this is why we've got those are fine, those not too bad at all. It's the fact they've been trying to bend bigger stuff, too big for it, and you can just see the little rays there. And of course what that is doing is that that is not giving us the clamping force to hold that toe, and a loose toe is just, well, it's just no point. It's ridiculous. So there we go. So that's what I'm up to, sorting out all of these one at a time, trying to get them all lined up. You can see that there are issues here with alignment. These are in tight, just got to figure out where the alignment issues are. We got things underneath, rails underneath, to clean and to make sure that all that's clear. Like I say, I'm gonna have to take off these little nipples. So there you go. Well, if you, as always, get the dirty bit out of the way. If you like the videos, please subscribe. And hopefully I can carry on making them and make them somewhat more interesting. What I'll do is I'll do an update a little bit later today, once I've got all of this sorted, if I can get it sorted. And we'll catch up later. Okay, take care now. Cheers.